please like, please like. Anyway guys, if you haven't checked out my last videos, I have 2 videos up so far, about the last one about the red sand beach and the one for the Dinyandi Falls. Please go check them out. Mira Mathisen on the my YouTube name, and yeah, I just show you around things that I find across in Iceland, and they're so beautiful, like things I've never seen before that I think are so beautiful. It's quite bold. So yeah, I make sure to document them and show you guys. I hope you like them. And yep. Have you back today. Now I'm taking you to Reykjavik, the capital city. Before I was taking you all over the suburbs, or you know, outside the city. So today we're going to the city, to Reykjavik, the capital, and I think it's gonna be fun. At least let's see some people, let's see some city houses, you know, buildings and stuff. Most of the people actually in Iceland live in the capital, which is quite rare, especially in Europe. Most people are all over the cities, other municipals, but this in particular Iceland, most people live in the city. One fun fact, second. Yes. Anyway, they have the largest puffin population in the world. It has 60% of the puffin population in the world. So Reykjavik, I think it's outside Reykjavik, on an island called Ubre. If I'm saying that wrong, I'm sorry guys, but I would put the name right here below. Iceland has the 60% population of these puffin. Puffins are birds. I'll put also the picture of it. Some of you who don't know the puffins, I didn't know about the puffins. I don't know if they're puffins or puffins, but anyway, I'll put the picture of that. So yeah, it has the largest puffin population. It's really, really good. And actually Reykjavik also doesn't have like Starbucks, it doesn't have McDonald's. Quite rare for to not have those, you know. So standards are quite high. They're street food, they say they're street food, the standards are really high. So if you don't meet their standards, wow. Anyway, they have really good food in Iceland in general, whether it's like a quick stop, a small restaurant or whatever. They really have very, very good street food. So you doesn't even consider street food. It's really, really, really good. See you at... I'll put out my camera when I see something nice like this one. What do you think? So I'll see when I get to the city. Sorry, I was zoomed in before, super zoomed in the camera. I need to, I'm getting used to this. But anyway, I'll see you. I'll check out my camera from time to time when I see something nice that I think you would actually love. Yep, I'll take you out for sure. Bye. but I have to show you the horses. Okay, I have to show you the horses. Icelandic horses are really, really, they adapt to any weather, especially in the winter they're out. So take a look. Hey horsey. Yeah, we were just driving by and we saw them just on the road. They're so cool. So yeah, I think it's like a farmer's place right there. Is here. It's super nice. Guys, those are the horses. Wow, wow. In the background, you can see them. Yeah. So horses. But I don't want to leave. But we have to go. Okay, lucky. Guys, you've seen those horses. Like, honestly, they are special horses, a special breed of horses. I'll put their details in the description box on this video. These horses are majorly Icelandic. They adapt to the weather. Usually in the winter, I've seen them outside. You may feel sorry for them, but it's just that special breed. They have not seen any big horses, like really big in size. No, they are kind of like average size. I don't know if that's how they're meant to be or it's that type of breed, but that's one thing I wasn't prepared to see, but I saw. Yes, your adventure through my lives, guys. Thank you for supporting. I hope you liked, actually I hope you liked the last videos that I put up. Please, if you haven't watched, go watch about the Dinyendi Falls and then the Rauda Sandu Beach, the Red Sand Beach, and about, yeah, that we came across a black church, like black painted church, you know. Anyway, you just go check out those videos that I put up. But yep, still on the road to Reykjavik. Guys, I don't know if you can see those things that I'm seeing. It may be quite windy, but I don't know if you see the things that I want to show you. They're like small natural pools with hot water. Naturally, they are hot. They have hot water, you know, from the ground. So it's a natural thing, it's a geographical thing. So, yep, I'm gonna flip you around. And, yep, that's right it. I told you I'm gonna show you different things that I come across along the way. So yeah, sorry I can't go any closer than this, but yeah, that is one right there. You see that? There's like a barrier, I can't go closer than that, but I think they just put it there to protect, to conserve things like this, otherwise maniacs like us can go in there. I hope you enjoyed that small adventure as well. These are the things I literally came across along the way as a friend. Yes, you know? So yeah, that's it. It's quite cute. It's really, really cute. I hope you like. Thank you. here. This is key ring. See, guys, look at the example of that. 4,100. That is about. That's about $41. This is a key ring, but I think it's made from the local for the Icelandic. You guys can tell this, like lapi, like a keeper, something like that. So.